For those of you who haven't seen us before, by way of brief introduction, this is Johnny, I'm Chris. We both play piano and we both play cello. This is our first concert back in Arizona since we performed in Carnegie Hall a couple of months ago. Johnny and I just spent a little over a month traveling in Europe. We got to perform in Poland, Austria, and Hungary, work with director of piano at Vienna Conservatory. It was an amazing trip. Thank you. actually do know Beethoven did not play Boogie Woogie. It is true. Most people associate the origins of Boogie Woogie with the swing era, the 1930s, people like Louis Armstrong, Duke Ellington, like that. But it actually got its start 100 years earlier in the 1830s. It was an attempt by African slaves using mostly drumming techniques to describe what it was like to hear the first trains coming through the quiet agrarian South. So you get sounds that represent the engine, and the whistle, and other things like that represented all through the music. And of course, trains were such a symbol of freedom at that time for America. So right as Chopin and Liszt were writing what they were in Paris, Boogie Woogie was getting its start in the American South.
Similar to Chopin, one of the defining experiences of Rachmaninoff's life was that of being in exile. In 1917, he and his family would have been targets during the Russian Revolution, and they fled. They actually fled to Finland on a sled.
Chopin died when he was very young. He was only 39. He had to flee Poland when he was about 18 years old. Poland was overrun by Russians and Prussians and Austrians, didn't exist as an independent nation for 123 years, including the entirety of Chopin's life. But it did exist as a culture and as a heritage, and Chopin is one of the ones who's greatly credited with keeping it alive in his music. He's an amazing storyteller in so many ways. Poles recognize themselves and their history in his music. Before Chopin died, he asked his friends in Paris, including Franz Liszt, that when he died, they remove his heart, which they did. They preserved it in a crystal urn in some kind of alcohol, they think brandy, and his older sister Ludwika took it back to Poland, where it is still interred in a huge column of the Holy Cross Church in Warsaw, under an inscription from Matthew 6:21, "Where your treasure is, there will be your heart also." And it was Chopin's way of saying that his treasure was his relationship with God and with Poland.
Thank you.
Being Polish, we're also Polish-American, and that means that the American side of us is going to be represented next. The reason Johnny and I started to play music was actually that we met the two ragtime piano players at the end of Main Street at Coca-Cola Corner in Disneyland. Which, when we tell our classical music friends that our earliest roots are in ragtime, they look at us and say it's like you're raised by wolves, but...